Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent, and this is Unité 10, Leçon B. And in this lesson, we'll discover together le passé du subjonctif. So remember, in the previous video, we saw le présent du subjonctif. And in that video, or in this video, we'll discover together how to make this past form of the subjonctif. Okay? So as in all the videos I've been making for the tenses or the modes, then it will be divided in two parts. The first part, l'utilisation, or l'emploi, when do we use it? And then the second part will be la formation, so how do we construct this passé du subjonctif? Okay, so let's start with l'utilisation. And so remember that we will use this passé du subjonctif to express, of course, something that happened in the past, but then the expression of le regret, la satisfaction, la désapprobation, and la surprise. Okay, so if you want to express this regret, satisfaction, désapprobation could be translated as disapproval, and then surprise. Okay, so the first one, regret. Okay, let's have a look at it. And we've got these structures. C'est dommage que, okay, it is a pity that, okay, and then if you continue with a past structure, it should be at the passé du subjonctif. Dommage que, well, exactly the same thing, but then it's more spoken because you've been dropping the subject and the verb, okay? So you can use that orally. In maybe not in formal situations, it would be better to use this c'est dommage que, okay? And then regretter, to regret, que, okay? And after that, you should put this passé du subjonctif, of course, if what comes after should be at the past form, all right? Then we'll see la satisfaction, okay? So here are the structures that we could use. C'est bien que, it is good that. Je suis content que, I am happy that. Or then, just as we had previously, content que, okay? So you just drop the subject and the verb, subject and the verb, and then in that case, it's more spoken, less formal. And ça me fait plaisir, it pleases me, that. Okay, so if you want to introduce something in the past after, it should be at the passé du subjonctif. Désapprobation, and so we could have this, ça m'ennuie que, it annoys me that, ça m'agace que, it bothers me that, je ne comprends pas que, I don't understand that, okay, and the same thing, what's coming after. If you want to express something in the past, then it should be le passé du subjonctif. And last but not least, la surprise, the surprise. C'est bizarre que, bizarre, strange. It's strange that. Je ne comprends pas que, I don't understand that. C'est drôle que, it's funny that. And if you want to express something after, at the past, it should be le passé du subjonctif. Okay, so now we'll see how to make this passé du subjonctif. And first, well, the best way will be to have a look at, well, this first sentence, que je mange, and it is the subjonctif present form, okay? And the second one, que j'ai mangé. This is le passé du subjonctif. Second example, que tu regardes. Same thing here, you've got the subjonctif présent. And que tu aies regardé. Here, you've got the subjonctif passé. And the third example, qu'il aille. So it's the verb aller, to go. And it's the subjonctif présent. Qu'il soit allé. And here we've got as well le subjonctif passé. So if you have a look at it first, what can you spot? You can spot that first here and here you've got avoir, okay, the subjonctif present form. And then after that you've got this participe passé here and here. And here we've got être. And after that, we've got the participe passé form. So, from what you see, And so especially now this is unit 10, so I assume that you've been watching the previous videos that we've been making or I've been making concerning the composed tenses. And maybe here you can see that actually this passé du subjonctif will be constructed like all the composed tenses that we saw so far. So first, avoir, and then it should be at the subjonctif présent form. Then you will put your participe passé, and you will get your subjonctif passé. Or in some cases, you will use être at the subjonctif présent form, then the participe passé, and you will get your subjonctif passé. So it's basically, it's quite interesting because this passé du subjonctif is not really, really tricky when you think about the way it is made, okay? Because it will follow exactly the same rules as we've been seeing so far. So first, if you're not sure, you put avoir, okay? But then definitely you should know the conjugation of avoir at the subjonctif présent form. Then you will put your participe passé and you'll get your subjonctif passé. Remember, for être, as usual, we're talking about exceptions. And here they come. Aller, to go. Arriver, to arrive. Descendre, to go down. Devenir, to become. Entrer, to enter, to come in. Monter, to go up. Mourir, to die. Naître, born. Partir, to leave. Rester, to stay. Retourner, to return. Sortir, to go out. Tomber, to fall. Venir, to come. All these verbs will be requiring être at this passé du subjonctif. Okay, and then, of course, as we saw previously, all the reflexive verbs, so se regarder, s'appeler, for instance, se présenter, they will require être. So as long as you've got these verbs, you know, se something, then you should keep in mind that you will have to construct them with être. And of course, they will behave a bit differently because you will have to add little things, but we'll see that in this lesson, don't worry. Okay, so now we should definitely review one more time the subjonctif présent form of avoir and être, because these are the first forms that we will use to construct this passé du subjonctif. Okay, and so avoir goes like que j'ai, que tu es, qu'il est, qu'elle est, que nous ayons, que vous ayez, qu'ils aient, qu'elles aient. All right, so remember, one more time. Que j'ai, que tu es, qu'il est, qu'elle est, que nous ayons, que vous ayez, qu'ils aient, qu'elles aient. All right, and then être will go like que je sois, que tu sois, qu'il soit, qu'elle soit, que nous soyons, que vous soyez, qu'il soit, qu'elle soit. Okay, and then one more time, just for the fun. Que je sois, que tu sois, qu'il soit, qu'elle soit, que nous soyons, que vous soyez, qu'il soit, qu'elle soit. Alright, so try to remember them by heart, because especially if you want to construct this passé du subjonctif, these forms are the first one that you will have to put, okay? Normally the second part, well, at this point you should start to remember them. I mean, this participe passé form should be quite okay, but then don't worry, we'll work on that, okay? Because, well, the thing you get to remember when it comes to the participe passé form is that for the first group of verbs, or regular verbs ending with ER, it will be quite easy, because if we take the verb parler, to talk, to speak, So it's ending with this er, and then this participe passé will be parler with the accent. Okay? Regarder, to watch, same rule, it will end with this accent aigu. And then even aller, you know, this tricky verb from the third group, aller means to go, even this one is quite easy when it comes to the participe passé because it will be aller. Second group of verbs, not all the er, remember, but then regular, and they're quite easy to make because the verb like choisir, to choose, so ending with er, will become choisi. Okay? Finir, to finish, to end, will become fini. Alright? And then unir, to unite, will become uni. Alright? So er will become Of course, the third group of verb is quite tricky. I've been making a video regarding this participe passé thing, so if it's not clear for you, I would advise you to watch this video. But then, well, some subgroups, but of course they don't include everything. But so far, let's do that. So, eu, connaître, to know, will become connu, okay? Voir, so O-I-R, will become vu, U, all right? So I, partir, will become parti. Rire, so I-R-E, will become ri, okay? And then the I-T, phonetically you pronounce I because final T is not pronounced, but still. Écrire, to write, écrit. By the way, partir is to leave, rire is to laugh, okay? So écrire, to write, will become écrit. Dire, to say, will become dit. All right, and then es now, final s not pronounced, but still you need to write it. Mettre, for instance, E-W-T-R-E, will become mis, es. Prendre, E-N-D-R-E, will become pris. All right, but then if you're not sure, as I said, watch the video because it will be useful. And then let's take the verb parler, as we had, and let's put the passé du subjonctif form, so it go like that. Que j'ai parlé, que tu aies parlé, qu'il ait parlé, qu'elle ait parlé, que nous ayons parlé, que vous ayez parlé, qu'ils aient parlé, qu'elles aient parlé. Alright, so as we saw, first you put avoir at the subjonctive present form, then you put your participe passé, and you will get here a beautiful passé du subjonctif. Okay? And if you noticed, I've been putting this E accent aigu in orange just to show you that in normal structures like this one, when you've got first the subject and after that the verb, you shouldn't put anything after your or at the end of your participe passé. So even if, like here, the subject is feminine, nothing comes after. Okay? So, que j'ai parlé, que tu aies parlé, qu'il ait parlé, qu'elle ait parlé, que nous ayons parlé, que vous ayez parlé, qu'ils aient parlé, qu'elles aient parlé. Alright? So, that's the passé du subjonctif for the verb parler, to speak or to talk. Okay? But then, of course, we've got some tricky things, and if you remember from the past tenses that we saw, it's exactly the same rule. If we take, well, these verbs that will require être, like you see here, qu'il soit allé, okay? Remember, we saw that allé needs to be conjugated with être, like here, qu'il soit allé. So here, allé will end with accent aigu like that. But then, if we put the feminine form, so qu'elle soit allée, it will be exactly as we saw for all the other composed tenses. You will have to put at the end of your participe passé the mark of the feminine, and at the end is the mark of the feminine. If you've got the plural, like here, il at the plural form, so soit, and then allée, well, you should put the mark of the plural at the end of your participe passé, and S is the mark of the plural. And last but not least, if you've got, like here, the feminine plural, so qu'elle soit allée, remember to put at the end of your participe passé first the mark of the feminine, so a, then the mark of the plural, s. The good thing, as usual in French, is you will pronounce it aller, 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 and aller. So technically you don't pronounce the final e, you don't pronounce the final s, and you don't pronounce the final es. But still, you should write them. Okay, so let's see now the full thing for aller, and it goes like that. Que je sois allé, okay, I won't make the liaison just to make it more clear, okay, que je sois allé, que tu sois allé, qu'il soit allé, qu'elle soit allée, que nous soyons allés, que vous soyez allés, qu'il soit allé, qu'elle soit allée. Alright, and now with the liaison, because I know that you want them. Que je sois allé, que tu sois allé, remember, no liaison when we've got these two. Qu'il soit allé, qu'elle soit allée, que nous soyons allés, que vous soyez allés, qu'il soit allé, qu'elle soit allée. Alright? And then, now we can see these famous verbs, reflexive verbs, okay, so the one that we saw with the se something, okay, que je me sois présenté, okay, so it will go like that, que je, and then remember for these reflexive verbs, you've got to put this me, so for je me sois présenté, okay, que je me sois présenté, que tu te sois présenté, okay, so we'll have to add this te, qu'il se soit présenté, qu'elle se soit présentée, que nous nous soyons présentés, que vous vous soyez présentés, qu'il se soit présenté, qu'elle se soit présentée. Alright, so remember, here, so you've got the option of the feminine, same thing here, so here the masculine because it's il, he, here you've got the feminine because it's elle, she, alright. Here you get the plural form, and then masculine plural, so E accent aigu S, and then E accent aigu ES for the feminine plural here, qu'elle se soit présentée. Okay? Alright, so if there is one thing to remember, it is the following. If you want to construct this passé du subjonctif, first you will have to put avoir at the subjonctif présent, then your participe passé, and you will get your subjonctif passé. In all these exceptions that we saw, être subjonctif présent and the participe passé, and you will get your subjonctif passé form. And that's it for le passé du subjonctif. If you want more videos, youtube.com/imagier, and then more material can be found here, www.imagier.net. Have a great day. Bye bye.